Of the nearly 2.5 million people incarcerated in America, nearly half of them are in jail because of drug use and addiction. There are more than 3,000 drug courts across the nation to help those with substance use disorders get and stay on the right side of the law. We're on location in Baltimore, Maryland, talking with the chief operating officer of the National Association of Drug Court Professionals about the success of drug courts in helping addicts recover and reduce crime. That's now on Connections.
And I think, you know, the war on drugs, I believe it was well-intentioned. You know, I grew up as a young man in the 80s, and I experienced and witnessed with my own eyes the harm done through the influx of drugs and the crack cocaine epidemic and all that came with that. And I saw families torn apart and people's lives shattered and, you know, children left fending for themselves. So I saw the harm, and I get the intention. But I think the unintended consequences of the war on drugs ended up with becoming, you know, sort of a war on drug users and people who were living with addiction as opposed to the drugs themselves. That wasn't the intention. I think that was the result. And so, frankly, drug courts, you know, developed during that period of time in, you know, the late 1980s, early 90s, sort of as an answer to this unintended impact of the war on drugs. So, you know, we got to find a new way to reference our approach to this, because I do believe that there is a growing consensus now. You know, drug courts believe this from the beginning, but there's a growing consensus now across the justice system, you know, coast to coast, across, you know, both parties, that we need another approach that emphasizes addiction being the brain-based disorder that we know it is, and finding, you know, smart, effective, compassionate strategies for dealing with it.
Stay tuned to Connections each week this summer for a series of episodes going inside opioid addiction.